just for me, the change from dating women to dating men was quite weird and strange, you know, because it's like, okay, this is weird. Hi, I'm Lindani Ndwandwa. I'm 33 years old. I'm a fashion designer. I'm a stylist and a fashion entrepreneur. I'm also a child of God and a man of God and a pastor. I was born in Pietermaritzburg in KZN. I'm the first born of 6 kids. I was raised by my grandmother and of course my mom. So I'm a granny's boy, hey? They used to call me Mfana Gogo when I was young because me and granny were like this. When she went to town, I was with my granny. She forced me to go to church. Guys, my granny went to church every day. There's prayer, there's this, there's fasting. Guys, I was a church boy. I was forced to go to church, but I'm grateful now that I'm older because I realized that the man of God I am was because of my granny. She forced me to pray, she forced me to read the Bible, and those things have been instilled in me. And when other kids were playing soccer and running around, I was like, hey, come and pray. Hey, next door there's a funeral, let's go pray. Next door this is happening, go and do this. You know, so I was really raised to be a pastor. I was raised to be a church boy. One of the biggest questions people always ask me is, when did you know you were gay? How did you find out? What do you feel when you know that you're gay? And I think if I had to be honest about my journey, I grew up as a normal boy, as I had girlfriends, I did everything that normal boys do, even in terms of sports and stuff. But I always felt slightly different because I just felt like, yes, I want to play soccer with all the boys, I want to be in the rugby field, but there were days where I wanted to wear my granny's clothes and my mom's clothes, which was a bit weird for a boy. And there were days where I wanted to wear my mom's makeup, but this was like once in a while. I went through primary school and high school as a normal straight boy, had a girlfriend here and there. It felt good until I got to fashion school where everything changed. Now, when you get to fashion school, everybody's gay. I mean, everybody's gay. So I got there telling people, hey, man, I'm straight here. I want a girlfriend. And then they're saying to me, no, when are you gay? Like, ask, show me, what do you mean? And I was insisting that I'm straight. I kept on insisting that I'm straight. And I felt straight because I've always been with girls. It didn't make sense to call me gay. You know, even in fashion school, the whole of my 3 years in fashion school, I had girlfriends, did nothing gay, didn't kiss a boy. This was all in KZN, by the way. Then I relocate to Joburg, to SAPC, to get a job. Then I meet really gay people who were asking me out, saying, hey, I like you. And I met men who were asking me out. And it just felt weird, the idea of dating a man, the idea of having a boyfriend. Until I gave in to one guy and I'm like, okay, let me give this a chance. Dated the guy, what an awkward relationship. Guys, awkward. I'm like, not for me, I'm going back to girls. So then after dating this guy, I was like, maybe being gay is not me. Having a boyfriend is not for me. And then I had girlfriends. And then I met another guy also in the future who said, okay, let's try. Then I tried, guys, one more time. And then I was like, no, not for me. So for a long time, you know, I played this game of dating a boy, dating a girl, dating a boy, dating a girl. Very confused, you know, about my sexuality. Until at the age of 24, I got engaged. Then I got married, you know, to a woman wanting to have the beautiful family, you know, the wife and 2 kids. That didn't work out because I was gay, you know. Fast forward, when I was 29, I got divorced because the marriage didn't work out. And then I went full into dating men. And 4 years later, I'm still dating men and I'm happily gay. A life-changing moment in my life was when I got divorced. Firstly, divorce is difficult. It's difficult just to divorce on its own, but when you're divorcing and, you know, people are saying, are you divorcing because you're gay? Are you divorcing because you're unhappy in your marriage? What's going on? That was tricky. The church rejected me. The church rejected me for being divorced, for not fighting for my marriage, for not grabbing my ex-wife's hand and saying, okay, let's go pray about it, or let's go fix our marriage. At some point, I stopped going to church. I was angry at God. I was angry at the church. I was angry at pastors. Anybody who tried to come to me and open scriptures about being gay and divorce, I was like, leave my house, you know. I also went through a time where I was very depressed because now I was struggling to accept the fact that I am gay and love myself and believe that God loves me, because, you know, as a Christian, it's very hard to be gay because people are telling you being gay is a sin, you're gonna go to hell. And on the other side, I believe that God has called me and I have a purpose to be a pastor. So I struggled with the two, and I had to walk away from the church and walk away from God for a while and just find myself and ask myself, where to from here? What do I want to do with this? You know, so there was a journey in my life where it was just me and God, where I was asking God difficult questions. Am I really gay? Why did you make me gay? Do you love me? Have you called me? Have you chosen me? And that was a very, very life-changing moment in my life, you know, where I felt like this gay thing or this gay spirit was attacking me. This is when I was still not ready to come out and be fully gay. And I would run to church on Sunday and ask the pastor to lay hands on me and pray for me. And the pastor would say, yeah, I'll pray for you, my child. This is a spirit of the devil. This is Satan. You know, no, God didn't create gay people. God didn't create it to be gay. And he'll pray for me. And trust me, guys, for the Monday and the Tuesday, the first 2 days after prayer, I'll feel a bit straight. Okay, ngindoda manje yangi, right? Wednesday is back to square one. So I did this cycle for a long time until I saw what, you know, man, I'm actually gay, this thing won't go away. And also it doesn't make sense, it you know, it's not sustainable for me to run to church every Sunday for a pastor to pray for me to feel straight for 2 days. And that was also just depression and torture in its own way. You're feeling something but you're denying it, you know that you want to be this but you don't want to. And guys, going to black churches as a Christian is difficult because black churches are not here to support gayness. Hey, they are, it's taboo, they are bashing gay people. When you go to a white church, rather, that's more open-minded, it's a bit different because they speak of the love and the grace and the mercy of God. And I wish that black churches, black pastors watching this, you guys could just do things differently. You could preach love, you could preach mercy and preach the grace of God. And also please be more loving to your gay people in your churches, because some of the worship team leaders and some of the pastors themselves and some of the ushers are gay, but they're scared to come out because they're scared of being judged. So the church needs to look at this differently and do things differently. Now, I have an event called Fashion Meets Gospel, one of the biggest gospel and fashion events, you know, in Africa. I work with pastors, I work with gospel musicians. That also was quite hectic because now people are asking me, okay, now you're divorced and you're gay, should we still support you? There's a lot of division that happened. Some people stayed in my life and supported me. Some are like, I went out, I'm taking the bayako. I got a lot of attacks from social media. So I went through a lot, you know, I went through a lot of rejection. I had to just check who's on my side and who's not on my side. It was quite a very scary time of my life. But more than anything, I had to remind myself, I am loved by God. I am redeemed by God. And my calling and the calling upon my life remains, you know, and the calling is still calling. I think the most difficult thing in life is being gay and Christian. Christian people, firstly, I will just say as a fellow Christian myself, Christians are judgmental. I don't think the church at large and Christians in general understand what being gay means. People think being gay is something that you choose. People think being gay is just a fancy lifestyle that we just decide to walk into. I am gay, kumnandi, kufabulous, we're part of the LGBTQ community. Little do they know that it's very hard to be gay because, you know, people speak of coming out of the closet. It's a tricky one because, you know, you kind of want to tell your family and friends, hey, I'm gay, but also some of them know and they see it already. The other tricky part is that you also take the risk of being rejected, because what if they reject you and say, you know, I don't want to associate with you anymore because you're gay, or people start pulling away from you. So I did go through rejection. I never had a conversation with my family as such where I sat them down and said, hey guys, I'm gay. But I think they saw on social media, they saw in other TV interviews, you know, okay. And then I got SMSs and WhatsApp saying, hey, we saw your interview. Just know we love you. So my family loves me and supports me. But guys, being gay is difficult. It's difficult and nobody chooses to be gay. It's just a tricky one because, you know, I can never fully explain what it feels like to be gay, but being gay is like being straight. It's just who you are. It's something you don't choose. It's something you just wake up and that's who you are. One of the things that I want to talk about is just for me, the change from dating women to dating men was quite weird and strange, you know, because it's like, okay, this is weird. The first time I really not just me after my divorce, now I'm 29, I'm now coming out of the closet, I'm now fully gay, not afraid anymore, just living my truth and wanting to really have a boyfriend, not just a fling or just a hookup, like a real relationship with a man. That was tricky because, you know, it's even the roles, who's gonna cook, who's gonna bake, who's gonna clean the house, that was tricky. The whole journey of just being gay and out was a tricky one, but also exciting. Holding my partner's hand in the morning in public and not scared of what people will say was also interesting, because a part of you wants to just live your truth and not care about people, but a part of you is scared of the rejection and what might happen to you, you know. So you get scared to go to, what if I hold a man's hand and people start beating us up or something happens, you know. But I enjoyed the journey of falling in love with a man. I enjoyed the journey of having a boyfriend. I enjoyed the journey of loving a man, and it felt good. I can tell you even now, loving a man and having a boyfriend is amazing. I wouldn't have it any other way, and I would never go back to women. I'm in a very good space spiritually. Yo, my relationship with God is just outstanding. I always write down on Instagram and Facebook that I wake up sometimes and God is just in the room with me. It's the same experience that Adam and Eve felt, where God used to walk in the cool of the day and speak to them. I feel like what I've built with God, God doesn't need permission to visit me. He just comes. And because my heart is so open to receiving him, he always visits me. I've been ordained and anointed by God himself to be a pastor and preach the gospel. I'm already preaching the gospel on social media. I'm preaching on my WhatsApp statuses. I am not giving people a break and rest. I am preaching, guys.
What is your portion?
You are preaching. You are preaching. You are preaching.
It does not say you are placed. It says you are planted.
I've been called to preach the gospel, but I'm called for sinners. I want to say this clearly. I'm called for sinners. I'm called for non-believers. I'm called for prostitutes. I'm called for murderers. I'm called for killers. I'm not really called for Christians who are judgmental, who are going to open scriptures and compare what I'm saying. I'm called for those who need Jesus. God has sent me to the world to preach the gospel. God has also sent me to my queer family, the gay family, my gay brothers, my lesbian sisters. I'm going to preach the gospel, and I want us to be, you know, the gays for Jesus, the gays who love Jesus. And we need to be bold and know that God loves us and we are made in his image. So even if you are watching this now and you are there, you are lesbian, you are gay, you are transgender, and you think there is no place for you in the church, there is place for you in God. There is place for you in God's heart. And God loves you equally as he loves a straight person. God loves you equally like everybody else. And gay people should never feel like God loves you less. There is nothing wrong with you. You are not a sin and you are not a sinner. You are a product of God's love. You are made by love. You are made with love by God. You know. And I want everybody watching this to know that all of us have a purpose. My purpose is to preach the gospel and uplift souls. And I will live my purpose till I die. And I will never let any man of God, any bishop, any archbishop, any deacon to tell me otherwise and say, because you're gay, God can't use you. That is nonsense. That's a lie from the enemy. God knew who I was. The Bible says in the book of Jeremiah 1 verse 4 and 5, before I formed you in the mother's womb, I knew you and I set you apart. God knew who Lindani was. God knew that I was gay. God knew I'll go through a divorce. God knew everything about me, and he ordained me from birth. So I was born ordained, I was born anointed, I was born appointed, and I walk in the confidence knowing that I've been made by God himself. And the Bible says the steps of the righteous are ordered by God. Everything I am now at the age of 33 here on YouTube, you know, speaking like this by God, it's ordained by God. Me preaching on Instagram, it's ordained by God. So I am walking in the steps of God, because I am the righteous and my steps are ordained. Amen. Hi, I'm Lindani Ndwandwa. I am 33 years old and I've been through the most.